Thank you.
اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل محمد. الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن محمداً رسول الله. أشهد أن محمداً حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
Elhamdülillah, elhamdülillah, elhamdülillah. Estağfurullah, estağfurullah, estağfurullah. El-Azim, el-Lezî, la ilahe illa hu, el-Hayyul Kayyum. Ve etûb ileyk, ve selevtebete, ve mağfirete, ve hidayete. İnnehu huve tevvâbur rahîm. Ve afu anna ya kerîm, ve afu anna ya kerîm, ve afu anna ya kerîm. Ve affi lena bi fadlike bi rahman ya rahîm. Ya Melik'u, Ya Kudüs'u, Ya Hafız'u, Ya Allah. El evvel Allah, el ahir Allah, el zahir Allah, el batin Allah. Hayrihi ve şerrihi min Allahu Teala. Ve eşhedü en la ilahe illallah. Ve eşhedü enne Muhammeden abduhu ve resuluhu. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Resulallah. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Habiballah. Esselatu ve selamu aleyke ya Seyyidine levveline vel ahirin. İşfelene ya Şefiyel Müslübin. Bir rahmetike ya Rahman Rahim. Kâlallahu Teâlâ fî kitâbel kerîm. Euzu billâhi mineşşeytânirracîm. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Kûlû âmennâ billâhi ve mâ unzile ileynâ ve mâ unzile ilâ İbrahîme ve İsmaîle ve İshâka ve Yâkûba vel esbâd. والأسفات وما أوتي موسى وعيسى وما أوتي النبيون من ربهم لا نفرق بين أحد منهم ونحن له مسلمين. الله تعالى says in Kitab al-Kerim, say, we believe in Allah. And that which has been sent down to us, and that which has been sent down to Abraham, Ishmael, Ishaq, Yaqub, and to Asfar, the 12 sons of Yaqub, and that which has been given to Moses and Isa, Jesus, and that which has been given to the prophets from their Lord, we make no distinction between any of them. And to him we have submitted in Islam. We believe that there is one God and there is one message. And with his infinite mercy, Allah Ta'ala did not leave us in ignorance about his message. He has sent down 124,000 messengers to preach us the same thing. He did not send messengers to different people to cancel the message that he has sent before, or to conflict, or to create conflict. There was one truth, one message that was preached by all. Prophet Adam, starting from Prophet Adam, Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jacob, Joseph, Zechariah, Jesus, and lastly, Prophet Muhammad Mustafa. Peace and blessings to all upon them. We do not make distinction between them as far as their teachings are concerned. Being a Muslim is believing all the prophets and their message, following all of their message. Many Christians celebrated yesterday is the birth of Prophet Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him. Since it is the season, I thought it was time to talk a bit about Prophet Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him. Prophet Jesus was one of the mightiest prophets of God. He was born miraculously, as you know. He gave life to death. He has opened the eyes of the blind, who were born blind, who cured lepers. In one occasion, he made a bird out of a clay and blew into it, and made a living bird out of it. He had miracles. One of the most important characteristics of Prophet Jesus. He was called Ruhul Kudus, the Spirit of Allah. It is extremely difficult to follow his example. But one of the most important characteristics of Prophet Jesus was that he did not have worldly possessions. He had a cup with which he used to drink water. And one day when he was walking, he saw some men using their hands to drink water. He gave his cup away. He had a bone, narrow teeth bone. He used to use that to comb his hair. When he saw someone using his hands to comb his hair, he gave his comb away. When he died, the only possession he had was a needle that he used to sew, to repair his clothing, and to pick the thorns from his skin. And they say that because of the weight of that little needle, when he had difficulty being ascended to the highest heavens because of the weight of that needle, while he was being raised to the highest heavens. It's ironic how we celebrate, how people celebrate in the world the birth of Jesus, which is an extremely important event, the birth of venerable Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, who had no possessions. Isn't it ironic how we celebrate his birth in the West? Rather than using this opportunity to understand his beautiful character and trying to take examples as much as we can and apply that examples into our lives, we just do the opposite. There is a free encyclopedia which is called Wikipedia. A lot of people contribute to it. It's kind of voice of the people. It is built over the years. About the significance of Christmas, I gather these from Wikipedia. Christmas is very significant in the Western world. And the significance of the birth of Jesus is explained with the following words. The Christmas is significant because Christmas is typically a peak selling season for retailers in many nations around the world. Christmas is significant. Sales increase dramatically as people purchase gifts, decorations, and supplies to celebrate. Christmas is significant. The buying surge 100%, sometimes 200% in different sectors. Christmas is significant. 2 billion Christmas cards are sent in the US alone. Christmas is significant. 2 million live Christmas trees are cut every year. Another gain is economic stimulation. But I'd like to hope and pray that the only thing that we retain as a result of celebrating the birth of the mighty prophet is economic stimulation. Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, as one of the mightiest prophets of God, one day they saw him running away in a hurry. And they asked, "Oh, the Spirit of Allah, where are you running off?" And venerable Jesus, peace and blessings be upon him, said, "I am running away from a fool." And they asked, "O Prophet of Allah, you have restored life from them. You have opened the eyes of the people who were born blind. You cured the lepers. From whom you could be afraid of?" And Jesus, peace and blessings upon him, said, "The who?" And they said, You have the cure of everything, even to death. Don't you have a cure for the fool? Don't you have any remedy for the fool? The Venerable Jesus said, the dead may be brought back to life. The eyes of the blind may be opened. Leprosy can be cured. But there is no remedy for the fool, because the fools are subject to Allah's wrath. Who is a fool? Who are those fools that they cannot be cured? Who are these fools that there is no remedy for them? Who are these fools? Even the mightiest prophets of God is running away from them. These are not the people who are less intelligent. On the contrary, many fools are more intelligent than you and me. But their intelligence is only useful to gather worthy possessions at the price of other people. When it comes to read the divine signs of Allah Ta'ala, they are blind. Not that they don't see, they refuse. They refuse to see the divine signs of Allah Ta'ala. These are the fools. They look, but they don't take lessons. These are the fools. They say that if you use your eyes to look, and if those eyes are not taking any lessons from the mistakes of your own or others, those eyes are enemies at the top of your head. These are the fools. Fools are those who do not reason, who do not contemplate on things, on events surrounding them. They don't take lesson. When they don't take lesson, they think they have the solution. They do not believe in that there is nothing impossible for Allah Ta'ala, but they believe that with their own power they can do things. Shaitan al-Ayn was a fool. An intelligent fool. He did not want to prostrate in front of Adam. He denied to see the signs of Allah Ta'ala in front of Adam. He was the fool. He closed his eyes to the signs of Allah Ta'ala. Because he was arrogant. Arrogance made people fool. To think that they deserve things more than anybody else. Make people fool to the truth. A man had a will. And in his will, he requested from his son that I'm leaving you with this 100 pieces of gold. I'm going to die soon. When I die, I would like you to take this 100 pieces of gold, find the biggest fool, and give this 100 pieces of gold to that fool. And he died. The boy took the 100 pieces and started looking all silly, stupid things around him, trying to find the fool to deliver, to discharge from his duty. Finally, while he was looking for the fool, he came to a palace. There was a gathering, and everybody is watching something. He approached, and they explained. They said that the Grand Vizier did something to displease the Emperor. The Emperor was very upset that now, today, they are going to execute him. They are going to kill him. We are here to watch his execution. And then after that, the next Grand Vizier is going to be picked. The next Grand Vizier after his precedent, after the old Vizier was killed, he is going to step over his body. And he was going to install his new position. So everybody's watching. Actually, really, they brought someone with handcuffs, pleading forgiveness, crying, asking forgiveness from the emperor, but they did not listen to him. They forced him to kneel, they cut his head off. And then the minister, who was watching all these things, stood up, stepped over his body, and then set his grand vizier down. And after that, the ceremony was over. Everybody came to congratulate the grand vizier. And then the boy with his 100 pieces of gold approached to the new vizier who was sitting in his throne. Sir, this is my father's last will. Please accept this 100 pieces of gold and discharge so that I will be discharged from this duty. He was surprised. Is this your father's will that you take this 100 pieces of gold and give to the Grand Vizier? No, he said. My father wanted me to find the biggest fool and give this 100 pieces of gold to the biggest fool. Grand Vizier was upset and asked, What makes you think that I am the greatest fool? The boy said, just a minute ago, I was watching that the old vizier was executed because he said something to displease the emperor. They killed him. You stood up, stepped over his body, assumed your new position. And what makes you think that tomorrow you're not going to displease the emperor? How could be someone so fool that deny that the same thing could happen to him the next day? You must be the biggest fool. And then he walked away. That is being a fool. Looking at the events around us, not taking any lessons, and thinking with arrogance that we have the intelligence, we have the power, and we're not going to make the same mistakes other people did. That is the definition of Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, all the most merciful, most compassionate. Look upon us with your mercy. You have given us a beautiful religion. You have given us Iman and Islam. Protect our Islam, protect our Iman, protect our Islam. Make us recognize our responsibilities as your supreme creation. As a human being. When you test us with little difficulties, give us patience. When you pour upon us your bounties, teach us to be thankful. And unify Ummat Muhammad. And increase our love and compassion towards each other. Bring us as one single family. Ameen, ameen, alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammadin maqtala al-malawan wa ta'aqaba al-asaran wa karrar al-jadidan wa istakbal al-fahadan wa darik al-ufahul arwaha ayti beytihi min al-tahiyyata wa salam wa barik wa sallim alayhi kathiran وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى جميع الأنبياء والمرسلين والأولياء والصالحين وعلى ملائكتك والمقربين وعلى طاعتك اجمعين من أهل السماوات وأهل الأرض ورضوان الله تعالى على آل رسول الله وأصحابه اجمعين آمين آمين والحمد لله رب العالمين.